の科学者クワメ。
Give it up for my sister, Misha, for 11. Yeah.
The first queen that we're going to honor today is not here because she's being awesome, which is one of the reasons that we're honoring her in the first place. But she sent her king to accept her award for her. So I'm just going to give you a little bit of information about Miss Toyin. She is affectionately known as Black Isis or the Black Malibu Barbie. Very much for you. Or just Toy. She's had over 25 years of managerial experience and held positions of leadership at UPS and from human resources to health and safety management and training and developing managers of all operations, vice presidents of people, vice president of Poet, which is a community activist-based performance organization. Toy is not only a life coach, community activist, mentor, mother, friend, and leader, and confidant to many. She is most importantly a woman who loves God. So right now, coming to accept her award and also give y'all a little something from his team, Poet, with him. Black Ice.
Hey! What's up?
Hey! You must be my soul sister. Soul sister. Y'all help me out. What? You must be my soul sister. Soul sister. I thank you, y'all queens.
You must be my soul sister. Soul sister.
Hey! You must be my
soul sister. Soul sister.
Yo, no.
Black queens,
right.
You are Wonder Woman. Not the fictional character we see on the cartoons, although you've been called an Amazon.
All right.
See, you can be a mom of four boys, the calm in the midst of a storm. See, you are Wonder Woman.
Hey.
You can carry babies inside of you for 9 months. You can hang with the boys, play spades, and talk.
All right.
See, what you do on an everyday basis makes some of us men look like punks. Been known to make a meal out of scraps. Change diapers and tires on flats. Pat a baby on his back while taking a nap on your lap. You are Wonder Woman.
Hey.
You must be my
soul sister, soul sister.
You must be my
soul sister, soul sister.
Mama, you must be my
soul sister, soul sister.
Now check this out. See, you're up before the sun comes up.
Right.
Ironing clothes, packing lunches, and we can call you Layla Ali because you know how to roll with the punches.
Right.
See, you can do an 8-hour shift standing on your feet all day at work. Come home, cook and clean, help the children with their homework. Put the babies to bed, make sure your man gets fed, and at night, make it twerk. Because you are Wonder Woman. Not the fictional character we see on the cartoons. but a queen, the daughter of a king. See, Hollywood likes to glorify as fictional superheroes, but in my hood, Inglewood, we glorify our own super sheroes. You are great grands and grandmothers. You are aunts and mothers. You are sister nieces and daughters. You are CEOs, business owners, doctors, and lawyers, made in the image of God, with the gift of those lips and those hips, but even more of that.
Oh my.
You are all of that and a bag of chips. You are Wonder Woman. Destin Pichon, thank you so much. I want to say on behalf of my wife, who I had to take to O'Hare Airport yesterday. She flew to Los Angeles, California, because she is the most powerful black woman in the state of Illinois for UPS. She was promoted to the community relations manager for the state of Illinois, the state of Michigan, the state of Nebraska, and the state of Wisconsin. That means that any event that's going on that's going to benefit the community, she receives money and finances and sponsorship to sponsor those organizations and sponsor those events. So in reality, her job is to give away money. And we giving away money, well, she, UPS, is giving away money to the black and the brown community, y'all. Give it up one more time for my wife, Toya and Gray Hawthorne, a.k.a. Brown Voices.
Toy is a genius. She strategically put together events. Whether she's doing it from UPS or she's doing it from her own pocket, whether Ice is doing it from, you know, Poet, or he's doing it from his own pocket. Together as a team, they are like my favorite. I'm talking about these two together, baby, as a power couple. I'm talking about real black love.
I can clap for that. I can clap for black love.
And they really support each other. This lady is a genius, y'all. I've been on the front line with them, baby, out there feeding the homeless. We done fed the homeless. We done been in the jails. Yes. We done been everywhere. We done took like 70 youth to the movie theater to see my documentary. We done did everything but Toy. This lady is so amazing. I'm talking about the word strength. Whenever I think of the word strength in a dictionary, I just see her picture like that pose. She is so amazing, y'all. And I just wanted to honor her, because this lady is powerful. This lady, she talks for the broken. And everybody, when we go feed the homeless, they love her, y'all. They know her by first name. She treats them like they her first cousins. And it's just the coolest thing in the world, because she didn't have to be doing this. She could have been somewhere else spending her money on some nails or something, but she wants to spend her money every day she get to support the homeless. She got them coats. She got them gloves. They don't have to go up. She'll get them an apartment if she have to. So I just want to say on her work that she does for the community, the work that she does for the homeless, the work that she does for the broken. She has young ladies, like teenagers, y'all, that she talked to, that she has different events with. These young girls came in broken, and they done came out way better than they did when they first joined her. So on behalf of Purple Pieces, I just want to say God bless. Tell Toy we love her. She couldn't be here today because she's out of town vacationing, sunning in the sun, and I don't blame her. So she working? Oh, I thought she was on vacation. Okay, that's even better. That's even better. That's what I'm talking about, y'all. So thank you, Ice. You and Toy, love you guys. Yeah. I'd like to present this award to Kai, to you, Carolyn. It says, Kai, it says, the voice of the broken. This lady fights effortlessly this is for her user so she can get an award. She fights effortlessly. She fights tirelessly for the broken, man. Any women that's going through sexual abuse, any women that's been through domestic violence, any one woman that's homeless, any like a single mother, you need somebody to talk to. Sometimes you can't talk to the counselors. Sometimes they don't understand, because To me, the best person to talk to is somebody that has the experience of what you've been through, because they're able to answer you better. They're able to help you better. The answers that they're giving you are coming from their heart, as opposed to a degree hanging on the wall, or as opposed to training that they had, or as opposed to a classroom that they sat in. The best trainer is experience. That's what I believe. So this lady here fights. She works for the NAACP, and she fights tirelessly, y'all, for black people. And I love her. She couldn't be here today because she had family emergency. But I just want to give this award to Kai. Will you kindly accept the award?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
You
want to say something?
Yeah. Okay. So just to piggyback off what you're saying, my cousin Kai, she's not blood, but she's definitely family. And as she said, Kai does absolutely support any and everyone on today. I was kind of having a battle of my own, just like, you know, getting one in the room who's, you know, has a history or been through something. I've been triumphant over my battles. And because of Kai, I have chosen to take new steps. And it's important to have people like that in your corner, because if you don't have that, a lot of those gifts and talents that lie dormant in you will cease to exist. And how do you spread the word of encouragement? How do you uplift? How do you inspire others with the gift that you possess if you don't have someone around you who encourages you? And so that's what Kai does for me. So if you said, like gentleman said, a mother with four sons, I have five sons. And so I had a little girl, and when I finally got that little girl, she passed away. And so I went into a very dark space, and I can just remember Kai telling me, well, do something with it. Don't die. Do something. And so with those words, I created my very own organization, A Parent Like Drea. So it's my daughter's name, Drea. Yeah, and so like she said, Kai is a wonderful woman. I hate that she couldn't be here to accept this. But on her behalf, I happily thank you.
And when I tell you that it be some days, it be so hard. It'd be so hard for her to move, and I could tell when she went through an episode because she started twiddling her fingers. Like she playing, start playing with glue. Y'all, this is my cousin, man. She fights so hard just to live every day, just to walk. They told my cousin that she was going to be sitting in a wheelchair, that she wasn't going to be able to walk. Yeah. So I had to honor her, because baby, you are my superhero, you my hero. Your super strength is so contagious. It's been days I wanted to just say forget it. You know, it's all this when I'm doing worth it. But after talking to my cousin, I'm like, nope, you gotta pull yourself up by the bootstraps and get yourself together, Janine. And I wanna say I love you so much, cuz. And I want to present her award.
This is our award, y'all.
This is Veronica. And her, I call her an angel. And she is an angel. So, a super strength, super woman. So, we can say something to you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Ron Fangel Hawkins. I'm a proud parent of three. Plus one. Yes, I said plus one. What's my plus one? My grandson. Yesterday was his birthday. I'm back on my run now. Thank you. Thank you very much. Gotta go.
They claim to be a friend of a family. She gave it to the boy across the street because he called her pretty. She let the girl down the street kiss it for experimentation. See, she ain't even like sex, just the moans of appreciation. Shorty, She wasn't stupid. She gave a speech at graduation. Then she graduated salutatorian, went to high school and majored in farming. Caught a few curable STDs from a grown man who raised her constantly. See, he be an admin and a smile with his money. She was lost. And she had paid the ultimate cost. See, her soul she had given to a policeman with a big truck that sold drugs for a living. In this life, she couldn't be. It felt as though she was defeated. And with no will to persist with the rusty razor, she went for her wrist. A year later, she tried to cure her pain with a bottle of aspirin. She didn't die, but the doctors discovered an allergic reaction. And that's when her parents stepped in, searched to find somebody for her to talk to. But there really wasn't much that a counselor could do. It wasn't until she had a conversation with a banker named Denise that all of this self-hate and self-mutilation would cease. See, Denise told her about Jesus and riches untold. Man. Showed her the inner beauty that she would always hold. Right. Gave her a pin and patted her to go. Say so. Now, when the truest spirit of testimony, I gotta give it to y'all the way that it should be. See, I had been used by so many people, I thought that was my purpose. And I had been played by so many men. Xbox was written across my service. But like Xbox, I did a 360. Turn my life around and let God use me. Continue to write and let him speak through me. And before I knew it, my soul was set free.
Yeah.
It's like I blinked and God had changed my whole life. Through God, I was transformed from a whore to a housewife.
Right.
Woo!
So the next time any of y'all in here ask me what happened, I'll tell you that my finger is literally shaped like my 96 Lumina gear shaft, because he was on the Lord path while hit me while I was driving.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you that the 43 stitches, the 23 stitches that I had in my face, the 23 stab wounds, the broken bones, the broken arms.
Mm-hmm.
But because as I didn't talk to him, I was giving him my money, he saw it as a sign of disrespect. And I'll tell you that the pistol whoopers that I literally endured each and every day still leave permanent migraine headaches to this day. Because on August the 18th, 2001, I got strangled to death. I was dead, flatlined, gone. And see, God gave my life back to me and gave him 15 years strong. So please support the message of God's awareness, my God. Not just October, but each and every day.
My name is Sheena Songstress, y'all. I'm really, really humbled by this honor. I don't like titles anyway, and I did send a bio. The young lady that she saved the other day was one of my students. I ain't gonna cry. She's 27, but I've been doing this over 15 years. I did it without a building. I did it without a paycheck. I did it because the most important thing in being a leader is being a servant. And if you don't know how to serve, how can you lead? I'm also a survivor of domestic violence. And it's not nothing I'm ashamed of, because I'm a conqueror. Matter of fact, I'm more than a conqueror. Oh, what God has for me, it is for me. This is what I say to myself. This is my thank you. What God has for me, it is for me. I remember when I didn't believe that. I know without a doubt, because Jesus brought me out.
Yes.
What God had for me, it was for me. Thank you, Nina, so much. I don't have nothing else to say.
The Shattered Innocence of Yaya Jackson and the Shattered Innocence of Yaya Jackson Workbook Journal, 12 Steps to Overcoming Sexual Abuse. She is the founder of Girl Be Beautiful, an organization whose mission is to inspire, encourage, motivate, and teach young ladies across the world the importance of knowing that they are beautiful. Founder of Creator of Life 24/7 Spa Training Academy and Create Life 24/7 Coaching and Mentoring Practice. She is an amazing woman. She continues to build her brand by staying active in the community and keeping abreast various projects and continuing to build her platform. Who's that lady? Thank you so very much, Nina, for this award. It was a surprise when she called me. I was like, wow, this is a blessing. I thank God for how he uses me. I am a trauma coach. I speak to the sexual abuse community as well as the domestic violence community. I've met some amazing women along the journey. I've helped some amazing women along the journey. And my work goes beyond anything that you can imagine. Just like Nina said, how we, you go and you get these women into shelters and you just don't know. I was at a school, Cook School, with ICE, Black ICE, mentoring some young ladies. And this young girl, she was sitting off to the side. It was probably about 30 or 40 girls in the gym. And I gave her my book. But before I gave her my book, I just talked to her. I knew that, I sensed that it was something going on with her. And so, me being a mandated reporter, I asked her a couple of questions and I knew it. I knew that she was being violated, right? So it just touched me that I was able to help see. First of all, God gave me the eyes to see. Like, I could walk up to people and just know, you know, women, and just know it's not nothing that, you know, I'm not trying to get in anybody's business, but it's just a gift that God gave me. And I'm able to speak into these women's lives and make a change right then and there, you know? And so I'm just grateful to God for this young lady for reaching back out to me, and that she was healed and taken out of that situation. I'm sorry, she's not healed. She's in the process of being healed. And so I just thank God for using me to do that. Yes.
So this is your award.
Thank you so much.
It's so pretty. It's like my Shiro. Survival is my new arrival. Oh, wow.
So emotional right now because I'm a living miracle walking.
Yeah.
I'm a recording artist. I'm a mother, I'm a daughter, I'm a sister, I'm an aunt, I'm a grandmother now. And I'm a living miracle walking. And my children and I survived a brutal stabbing by my husband last year. And I want to also honor my neighbor who saved us. I wouldn't be here. I don't think I would be here if it wasn't for her and her family. And I'm just so grateful because we've come such a long way. And I learned the song. I told Nina I was going to sing. I've been walking with my face turned to the sun, weight on my shoulders of a bullet and a gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head just in case I have to run. I do what I can, when I can, what I can for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill night the sky, that's why I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home far across the river. Can you hear freedom calling? Gonna keep on going. I feel it in my bones. I can feel it in my bones.
You are wonderful. You are my wonderful. Yeah. God, you are Wonder Woman, not the fictional character that I see on the cartoons. Although you've been called an Amazon, a mom of four boys, the calm before the confusion and the noise. You are Wonder Woman. You've carried babies inside of you for 9 months. You can hang with the boys, play spades and talk. You see what you're doing on an everyday basis. Make some of us men look like punks. Been known to make a meal out of scraps. Change diapers and tires on flats. Pat a baby on his back while taking a nap on your lap. You are Wonder Woman. Not the fictional character we see in the movies. See you up before the sun comes up. Ironing clothes, packing lunches. And we can call you Layla Ali because you know how to roll with the punches. You can do an 8-hour shift, standing all day on your feet at work. Come home, cook and clean. Help the children with their homework. Put the babies to bed. Make sure your man gets fed. And at night, make it twerk. Make it twerk. You are Wonder Woman. Not the fictional character we see in the movies. Not the daughter of Zeus, but the daughter of the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You're a goddess with beauty deep within. And it's not in your makeup, baby, it's in your makeup. Oh yeah. And you have superpowers too. See, Diana might have a lasso that makes men speak the truth. But listen, you have something much more convincing. You have an endless flow of words, enough to keep your mouth full. And your intuition can always tell you when us men be on some bull. And Wonder Woman may have super friends and a Justice League like Superman and Batman, who can take on any challenge. But you've got a whole team of people, of extraordinary talent. You are Wonder Woman, not the fictional character we see in the movies, but a queen, the daughter of a king. See, Hollywood likes to glorify as fictional superheroes, but in my hood, Inglewood, we edify our own superheroes. You are great grands and grandmothers, you are aunts and mothers, you are sister, nieces and daughters, you are executives, business owners, CEOs, doctors and lawyers, created in the image of God, with the gift of those lips and those hips, but even more than that.